enjoyed your Onam holidays. In this session, we'll complete the last part of the chapter, the 100 dresses 1, and move on to next part of it, that is the 100 dresses 2. So you all know Vanda Petronsky was a poor Polish girl, and Peggy, one of her friends, would always tease Vanda for her poor dress. Okay, now let us read the last part of the chapter together. Today, even though they had been late to school, Maddie was glad she had not had to make fun of Vanda. She worked her arithmetic problems absent-mindedly. 8 times 8, let us see. She wished she had the nerve, that means the courage, to write Peggy a note, because she knew she never would have the courage to speak right out to Peggy to say, "Hey Peg, let us stop asking Vanda how many dresses she has." When she finished her arithmetic, she did start a note to Peggy. Suddenly, she paused and shuddered. She pictured herself in the schoolyard, a new target for Peggy and the girls. Peggy might ask her where she got the dress that she had on, and Maddie would have to say it was one of Peggy's old ones that Maddie's mother had tried to disguise with new trimmings, so no one in room 13 would recognize it. If only Peggy would decide of her own accord, her own wish, to stop having fun with Vanda. Oh well, Maddie ran her hand through her short blonde hair. Blonde hair means pale golden hair, as though to push the uncomfortable thoughts away. What difference did it make? Slowly, Maddie tore into bits the note she had started. She was Peggy's best friend, and Peggy was the best liked girl in the whole room. Peggy could not possibly do anything that was really wrong, she thought. So one day, Maddie decided to write a note to Peggy, asking her not to tease Vanda anymore. Later, she tore it up, thinking that she might be angry with her and would tease her. So Maddie was also a poor girl, and she used to wear different dresses given by a rich family, and she feared that one day all the girls would be fed up of Vanda and she would become their next target. As for Vanda, she was just some girl who lived upon Boggins Heights and stood alone in the schoolyard. She scarcely ever said anything to anybody. The only time she talked was in the schoolyard about her 100 dresses. Maddie remembered her telling about one of her dresses, pale blue with colored trimmings. And she remembered another that was brilliant jungle green with a red sash. "You would look like a Christmas tree in that," the girls had said in pretended admiration. Thinking about Vanda and her 100 dresses all lined up in the closet, Maddie began to wonder who was going to win the drawing and coloring contest. For girls, this contest consisted of designing dresses, and for boys, of designing motorboats. Probably Peggy would win the girls' medal. Peggy drew better than anyone else in the room. At least, that is what everybody thought. She could copy a picture in a magazine or some film star's head so that you could almost tell who it was. Oh, Maddie was sure Peggy would win. Well, tomorrow the teacher was going to announce the winners. Then they would know. So there was a drawing competition for boys and girls in the class. Maddie began to think of the drawing competition that had been held a few days earlier. The results had not yet been declared. Maddie was certain that Peggy was going to win the contest. She could draw the faces of film stars so well, and also copy pictures from a magazine. The next day, it was drizzling. Drizzling means to rain lightly. Maddie and Peggy hurried to school under Peggy's umbrella. Naturally, on a day like this, they didn't wait for Vanda Petronsky on the corner of Oliver Street. The street that far, far away, under the railroad tracks and up the hill, led to Bogin's Heights. Anyway, they weren't taking chances on being late today, because today was important. "Do you think Miss Mason will announce the winners today?" asked Peggy. "Oh, I hope so. The minute we get in," said Maddie. "Of course, you will win, Peg." "Hope so," said Peggy eagerly. The minute they entered the classroom, they stopped short and gasped. There were drawings all over the room, on every ledge and windowsill, dazzling colors and brilliant, lavish designs, all drawn on great sheets of wrapping paper. Ledge means narrow, flat shelf. Windowsill means a narrow shelf below a window. Dazzling means very bright. Lavish designs, very grand or very impressive. There must have been 100 of them all lined up. These must be the drawings for the contest. They were. Everybody stopped and whistled or murmured admiringly. As soon as the class had assembled, Miss Mason announced the winners. "Jack Beggles had won for the boys," she said, "and his design for an outboard motor was on exhibition in room 12, along with the sketches by all the other boys. As for the girls," she said, "although just one or two sketches were submitted by most, one girl and room 13 should be proud of her. This one girl actually drew 100 designs, all different and all beautiful. In the opinion of the judges, any one of the drawings is worthy of winning the prize. I am very happy to say that Vanda Petronsky is the winner of the girls' medal." The next day it was drizzling. Vanda was absent this day also. The class teacher, Miss Mason, announced the results. She said that from among the girls, Vanda had won the contest. While others had submitted one or two sketches, Vanda had submitted 100 designs of dresses, all different and all beautiful. And in the opinion of the judges, each one was worthy of winning a prize. Unfortunately, Vanda has been absent from school for some days and is not here to receive the applause that is due to her. Let us hope she will be back tomorrow. Now, class, you may file around the room quietly and look at her exquisite drawings. The children burst into applause, and even the boys were glad to have a chance to stamp on the floor, put their fingers in their mouths and whistle, though they were not interested in dresses. "Look, Peg," whispered Maddie. "There is that blue one she told us about. Isn't it beautiful?" "Yes," said Peggy. "And here is that green one. Boy, and I thought I could draw." Okay, now try to answer these questions. Why didn't Maddie ask Peggy to stop teasing Vanda? What was she afraid of? Who did Maddie think would win the drawing contest? Why? Who won the drawing contest? What had the winner drawn? Okay, now let us move on to the second part of the chapter, that is the 100 dresses too. While the class was circling the room, the monitor from the principal's office brought Miss Mason a note. Miss Mason read it several times and studied it thoughtfully for a while. Then she clapped her hands. "Attention, class, everyone back to their seat." When the shuffling of feet had stopped and the room was still and quiet, Miss Mason said, "I have a letter from Vanda's father that I want to read to you." Miss Mason stood there a moment, and the silence in the room grew tense and expectant. Tense means worried. Expectant means hoping for something good. The teacher adjusted her glasses slowly and deliberately. Deliberately means slowly and carefully. Her manner indicated that what was coming, this letter from Vanda's father, was a matter of great importance. Everybody listened closely as Miss Mason read the brief note. "Dear teacher, my Vanda will not come to your school anymore. Jake also. Now we move away to big city. No more holler pollock. No more ask why funny name. Plenty of funny names in the big city. Yours truly, Jan Petronsky." A deep silence met the reading of this letter. Miss Mason took off her glasses, blew on them, and wiped them on her soft white handkerchief. Then she put them on again and looked at the class. When she spoke, her voice was very low. "I am sure that none of the boys and girls in room 13 would purposely and deliberately hurt anyone's feelings because his or her name happened to be a long, unfamiliar one. I prefer to think that what was said in thoughtlessness." Thoughtlessness means not caring about the possible effects of words or actions. "I know that all of you feel the way I do, that this is a very unfortunate thing to have happened. Unfortunate and sad both. And I want you all to think about it." So while the children were going round and having a look at the drawings, the class teacher, Miss Mason, received a note from the principal. She read it carefully several times and then asked the children to go back to their seats. The note Miss Mason had received was a letter from Vanda's father. The teacher read it to the class. Vanda's father had written that his Vanda and his Jay could no longer come to that school. He had said that they were going to the big city where they would not have to hear about their funny names. The teacher called it a very sad and unfortunate thing. She left it to the children to think about it and form their conclusions. Okay, let us continue reading. The first period was a study period. Maddie tried to prepare her lessons, but she could not put her mind on her work. She had a very sick feeling in the bottom of her stomach. True, she had not enjoyed listening to Peggy ask Vanda how many dresses she had in her closet, but she had said nothing. She had stood by silently, and that was just as bad as what Peggy had done. Worse, she was a coward. At least Peggy hadn't considered they were being mean, but she, Maddie, had thought they were doing wrong. She could put herself in Vanda's shoes. Goodness, wasn't there anything she could do? If only she could tell Vanda she hadn't meant to hurt her feelings. She turned around and stole a glance at Peggy. But Peggy did not look up. She seemed to be studying hard. Well, whether Peggy felt badly or not, she, Maddie, had to do something. She had to find Vanda Petronsky. Maybe she had not yet moved away. Maybe Peggy would climb the heights with her and they would tell Vanda she had won the contest. That they thought she was smart and the 100 dresses were beautiful. So Maddie was full of deep regret. She had never enjoyed Peggy's game, but she always stood by silently and made no protest. Now she realized that it was just as bad as or even worse than what Peggy used to do. She called herself a coward. Maddie decided that after school she would find out Wanda at Boggins Heights and tell her that she had won the contest. Now she didn't care how Peggy would feel about it. Okay, now try to answer these questions. What did Mr. Petronsky's letter say? Is Miss Mason angry with the class or is she unhappy and upset? How does Maddie feel after listening to the note from Wanda's father? What does Maddie want to do? Okay, now read the textbook and answer all the questions given. Meet you in the next session with the rest part of the chapter. Thank you.